everyone. Welcome to Yoga with Sinclair. Today is a nice, slow morning practice to wake you up, get your day started, and stretch out your body after that good night's rest that you hopefully got at this point in your pregnancy. It is safe for all trimesters, so wherever you are in your pregnancy, hop on your mat and get ready to get started. Today we're going to get started on the tops of our knees. So sitting in a nice hero pose, Virasana. I want you to sit up nice and tall if this is comfortable with your knees. If it's not, feel free to sit down on your bottom cross leg, whatever's most comfortable for you. Go ahead and loop those shoulders up and back, sit up nice and tall. We're gonna bring our hands to our belly, our eyes nice and closed. And just start to take really deep breaths here. In and out through your nose. Really bringing your attention to your baby, to your body. And imagining that with each inhale, you're breathing around your baby, giving your baby a nice big hug. Take a big deep breath in, breathing in lots of love, lots of positivity. On your exhale, just letting go of everything that no longer serves you. Let go of any negativity in your life. One more big, deep inhale. Let your baby know how much you love them. One more big exhale. Go ahead and flutter your eyes open, and first we can go ahead and start to stretch out the backs of our knees, the tops of our feet a little bit. So stay taking one leg back, stretching into your calf, pressing through your heel, pressing the ground away, and then the other leg, rocking a little back and forth. And from here we're going to come up, we're going to come into a broken toe pose. So try to curl all of your toes under. You want the balls, almost the ball of your feet, the pads of your toes down on the mat. And just stopping wherever this feels like it's enough for you. So you might stop right here. You might come all the way up. If this is too much, you can still always come up to here. You're just trying to open up the bottoms of your feet a little bit. Again, loop those shoulders up and back. I'm going to take my hands back behind me, press my knuckles down towards the ground, totally up to you. And from here, just start to take really slow neck circles. So moving as slowly as you can. Really getting into all those nooks and crannies. And pulling your arms back behind you, that's going to open up the front of your shoulders. So for me, I know during my pregnancy, my shoulders get really tight. Take your circle back the opposite direction. My shoulders get really tight. I feel like I'm really heavy in the front part of my body. So just working to overcome that. Nice and slow, we're going to release our hands, walk forward, and just start to spank out the tops of our feet. Some nice relief there. And we're going to do that one more time. So tucking those toes under. This time, we're going to come all the way up if you can. From here, I'm going to do a goalpost arms. So we're going to do this a lot throughout the practice today. So we're just going to inhale your arms all the way up. On your exhale, bring your elbows forward. Fingertips reach back. Your chest is lifting here. So getting a nice chest opener. Breathing into all that space you're creating in your upper body. One more big inhale. Exhale, very slowly walk those hands forward. And again, spank out the tops of your feet. And now just staying in your tabletop position, you're going to hug your baby close to your spine. Press the ground away, hands right underneath those shoulders, knees right underneath your hips. We're going to start to move with our breath. So inhale, drop your belly, look up. Exhale, press the ground away, round your spine. Inhale, looking up, tailbone up. Exhale, tucking everything in. Big deep breath in. Big deep breath out. And feel free to find some organic movement here. So I love to take side stretches, getting into my side body a little bit. And even on my exhale, on my cat back, I like to do the same. Inhale, big deep breath in. Big full exhale. One more time, big deep breath in. And big exhale. From here, we're gonna walk our fingertips forward just slightly. Tuck your toes under and make your way into a downward facing dog. So if you need to bend your knees, feel free to do so. You want your chest pressing back towards your knees. Your arms stay nice and strong. Press the ground away. Again, baby hugging into your spine. And just take a couple seconds here to pedal out your feet. Check in with your breathing. Make sure it's still nice and slow. Maybe pop your ankles a little bit. We're going to take a couple breaths here, just finding some stillness. Big inhale, big exhale. Big deep breath in, big exhale. Last time, big inhale, big exhale. Very slowly start to walk your feet up to meet your hands. Taking your time, we're gonna hang out in our forward fold. Take your knees, I'm sorry, take your feet wider than hip distance, as wide as you'd like for right here. We're gonna keep our knees bent, really relax over your feet. Let your head hang heavy, maybe grab opposite elbows, and just hang out for a little bit. Again, checking in with your breath. Maybe nodding out yes or no. Feel the weight of your head releasing from your upper back, from your neck. We're gonna release our hands, bend your knees, roll all the way up to standing arms, float out and overhead. And just like we did before, we're gonna come into a nice cactus arms here. So like a standing back bend, your chest is lifting, your tailbone pointing down towards the ground. Breathing as slowly as you can. Maybe taking your ears from shoulder to shoulder. Still reaching back. Go ahead and gently release your hands. Give your shoulders a nice loop or two. Big inhale, reach all the way up. On your exhale, we're gonna swan dive, lead with your chest, forward fold. Inhale, coming up halfway, press your chest away from your legs, feel your spine in a nice straight line. Exhale, fold it right back down, bend your knees, roll all the way up to standing. Same thing, big deep breath in, exhale, forward fold. Inhale, coming up halfway, press your chest out, fire up those back muscles. Exhale, folding right back down, bend your knees, roll all the way up to standing. Maybe roll up your wrists a little bit here. From here, we're gonna grab onto one wrist. Inhale, reach all the way up, dive to the opposite side. Breathing into that side body, really trying to get as long as possible. Big deep breath in, big full exhale. Inhale all the way up. Same thing, other side, grabbing onto the other wrist, diving to the other side, stretching out through your armpit, through your side body, breathing as deeply as you can. Big inhale, exhale up to center. Big deep breath in, exhale, forward fold. So moving on from here, we're going to inhale, press your chest away, flat back. Exhale, fold it right back down. From here, we're going to step back into our plank pose. So during the practice, feel free to take this plank pose. You can drop your knees if you'd like. If you drop your knees, make sure you don't drop them forward. You drop them back. Your hips are still in a nice straight line with your spine, so we're not in an all fours position. Baby hugging into your spine. So from here, on this first one, we're going to take a big inhale. Exhale, drop your knees. Lower yourself down halfway. Keep those elbows hugging in. Inhale up to your cobra pose. Shoulders pull back away from your ears. Lift your chest. Coming back into that half plank. Your belly is staying nice and strong here. We're going to tuck our toes and send our hips up and back to downward facing dog. Pedal out the feet once again. And nice and slowly walk your feet up to meet your hands. Bend your knees, roll all the way up to standing. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold it right back down, moving on once again, stepping it back into your full plank. If you're feeling strong, feel free to do a nice chaturanga with me. If not, you're more than welcome to take the previous vinyasa. Big inhale, exhale, halfway down. Inhale up to your up dog. Shoulders pull back, big deep breath in. Exhale up and back to your downward facing dog. Take a second to check in with your breath. Slowly make your way up to meet your hands. Bend your knees, roll all the way up to standing. Take a second to check in with your breath again. Maybe roll out your wrists. Big inhale, exhale, forward fold. A little different this time. Inhale, bring it up halfway. Exhale, fold it right back down. From here, we're gonna step our left foot back, press the ground away, try to arch your back, really get into those hips a little bit here. Big deep breath in. Exhale, downward facing dog. Keep your hands nice and strong. Hug your baby into your spine as you roll out into your plank pose. Big inhale. Exhale, halfway down. Inhale up to your cobra or your up dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. This time we're going to step forward with our left foot. Place it on the outside of your hands. Step that right foot forward, coming into a nice little squat here. Great for pregnancy, opening up that low back, opening up your hips. And inhale all the way up. Same thing, other side, big deep breath in. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale to your flat back. Exhale, folding down, stepping your right foot back this time. Arch your back. Chest up, chin up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Slowly roll out to your plank pose. Lowering halfway down. Inhale up to your chest opener. Pull those shoulders back. Hug your baby into your spine as you exhale, downward facing dog. This time, stepping your right foot up on the outside of that right hand. And coming into your squat. You can press your palms together to lift your chest. If you'd like to take a twist that is safe for pregnancy, you can take your left hand to the outside of your mat on the left side. Reach your right arm all the way up. Breathing as slowly, as deeply as possible. Exhale, coming down. Same thing, other side. Right hand reaches out. Left arm reaches up. Big deep breath in. Exhale, right back down and stand it all the way up. Building on that, big deep breath in. Exhale, forward fold.
to our downward facing dog. From here, I want you to inhale, reach your right toes all the way up. If you'd like, you can bend your knee, open your hip, get a nice side body stretch here. Inhale, exhale, step your right foot up and through your hands. If you need to move it, that's fine. We're gonna lower our left knee. So first, we're gonna come all the way up to our low lunge, Anjaneyasana, one of my favorites. Make sure your belly is still staying nice and strong here. That left hip is pressing forward, checking in with your breathing. And coming into those goalpost arms. So big inhale, exhale, elbows forward, fingertips back, chest is lifting. Nice relief after all those sun salutations. If you'd like a little bit more, you can release your hands, interlace them behind your back, and really lift your chest here. If you weren't awake before, I bet you are now. Big deep breath in. Big full exhale. Go ahead and gently release those hands. We're gonna place them down, frame your front foot. This time we're gonna rock back, opening up that right hamstring. Inhale, reaching your chest forward. Exhale, folding deep. Feel free to play around with your foot pointed and flexed. The stretch is up to you. It does feel different whenever you do your toes a different way. Big deep breath in, big full exhale. One more big inhale. Exhale, we're gonna rock forward. Again, coming right back up to that low lunge. From here, I want you to take your right elbow either down to your right knee, and you can reach that left hand all the way up. If you're feeling like this isn't that great of a stretch on that left side, you can take your right fingertips all the way down. Reach all the way up and over with that left hand. It's a great side body stretch, great left hip flexor stretch. Breathe nice and deeply. Big inhale. Exhale, fold it right back down, plant your hands. We're gonna tuck our left toes and step it back to downward facing dog. Pedal out those feet, notice the differences in your hips. Slowly roll yourself out to your plank pose, big inhale. Exhale, lower halfway down. Inhale, up to your cobra or upward facing dog, and exhale, downward facing dog. Go ahead and step that left foot up on the outside of your left hand. The right foot steps all the way up, coming into your squat for just a moment. Inhale all the way up. Same thing, other side, big deep breath in. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale up halfway. Exhale, folding down. We're gonna step our right foot back this time. Press your chest forward. Exhale, downward facing dog. This time we're gonna inhale your left toes all the way up. Again, if you'd like, you can bend your knee and open your hip. Big deep breath in. Exhale, stepping your left foot up and through your hands. Plant your right knee, untuck those toes, and inhale up to your Anjaneyasana. Feel free to roll up those wrists, reach your chest up. Big inhale, exhale, goalpost arms. Checking in with your breathing here. Checking in with your thoughts. Make sure they're still positive. Make sure they're still kind, especially to yourself. Release those hands, interlace them behind your back. Press them down and away from your body as your chest lifts. Wonderful chest opener here. Checking in with your breathing. Big inhale. Exhale, very slowly plant those hands forward. We're gonna rock back, stretching into that left hamstring. Make sure you're not coming down and sitting on that right heel, but you're staying up and over that knee. Inhale, reach through your spine, reach through your chest. Exhale, folding down. Again, playing around with pointing and flexing that foot. Big deep breath in, big exhale. One more big inhale. This time on your exhale, rocking forward. Coming back up into that low lunge, either taking your left elbow to your knee or taking that left hand down, reaching up and over through those right fingertips. Breathing as deeply as you can. Big deep breath in, exhale, folding right back down, tucking those right toes and stepping back to downward facing dog. Go ahead and pedal out those feet, maybe roll out your ankles. Big deep breath in, exhale, coming out into your plank pose, slowly lowering down. Flipping your feet and coming up to your upward facing dog. Big juicy inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Go ahead and step those right toes up on the outside of that right hand. Left foot on the outside of the left hand. Press your chest forward. And inhale all the way up. Alright, a little bit different this time. Feel free to grab some water if you need a little break. Always pause the video if you feel like this is a little too much for you. Alright, inhale, reach those fingertips all the way up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale to flat back. Exhale, folding it right back down. We're just going to step it back into a downward facing dog from here. Pedal out those feet. From here, we're going to inhale your right feet all the way up. Again, open that knee if you need to, if it feels good. Big deep breath in. And exhale, stepping that foot in between your hands. This time we're going to keep our left knee lifted. Inhale up to your high lunge. So warrior one variation. This time just focusing on getting into that left hip flexor. Reach your arms all the way up. Exhale, goalpost. Breathing nice and slowly. If you'd like, you can interlace those hands behind your back. Pull them down and away. Get a nice big chest opener. Gently release. We're going to inhale up. Exhale, open out into your warrior two. So right toes pointing straight forward. Left toes pointing towards the back if you're like me. Arms are staying out nice and strong, shoulders are relaxed. Feeling that heat we're building up in our legs, hugging your baby in towards your spine. From here, we're gonna drop our right elbow down. Inhale your left arm up and over. Nice extended side angle. Chest rotating up. One more big deep breath in, full exhale. reverse triangle. So straightening up that right leg, reaching your left arm back, your right fingertips all the way up. Getting a nice side body stretch on the right side. And coming back up through center, keeping your legs exactly how they are. Your hands are gonna come out to your sides. And like someone's pulling your right fingertips, you're gonna lean forward. Keep your core really tight here and drop down into your triangle pose. So this is great for your waist if you keep your stomach hugging in the entire time. Breathing nice and deeply. One more big deep breath in. This time on your exhale, we're going to fold down into pyramid pose. So your hips are now facing straight down, getting a nice hamstring stretch. And just like before, inhale, reaching out through your spine. Exhale, folding deep. Inhale, reach through that spine. Exhale, sinking deeper into that stretch. Last time, big inhale. On your exhale, we're going to bend down into a nice low lunge and step it back to down dog. Pedal out those feet. This time, reaching your left toes up on your inhale. Maybe opening up your hip a little bit here. Inhale all the way up. And exhale, stepping those left toes in between your hands and coming up into your nice high lunge. So really sinking into that left side to open up that right hip flexor. Trying to slow your breathing down. Big inhale, exhale, goalpost arms. Maybe release some tension in your neck by taking your ears from side to side if you can keep your balance. Baby hugging in. And release your hands behind your back, lift your chest. Very gently release, we're gonna inhale, exhale, open out to that warrior two. Reaching evenly through your left fingertips and your right fingertips. Your legs are nice and strong here. Big inhale, big exhale. We're gonna drop our left forearm down, reach those right fingertips up and over. Your core is strong, your chest is leaning back. Take all the bends out of that top arm. Finding a nice straight line from your right fingertips all the way down to your right toes. Inhale, coming up, straighten out that left leg. Reach your left fingertips up and over. Your right fingertips slide down that right leg. And again, coming up through center, keep that core nice and tight. Arms come out into a T, like someone's pulling you by your left fingertips. We'll slowly tip over into our Trikonasana, triangle pose. Great for the waist, great for those inner thighs. Feels awesome. Big deep breath in. This time on your exhale, folding forward over that front leg into your pyramid pose, your hips point straight down. Inhale, reach through your chest. Exhale, folding down. Inhale, reach all the way up. Exhale, folding down. One more big inhale. This time on your exhale, coming into your low lunge and stepping it back to downward facing dog. Pedal out those feet. Big inhale, exhale, roll out to your plank pose. Last one, you can do it. Exhale, folding down halfway. Inhale up to your upward facing dog. Shoulders roll back. Exhale, downward facing dog. And nice and slowly walk those feet up to meet your hands. We're going to take our toes pointing out and sink those hips down into a nice squat here. Lifting your chest, maybe taking a little twist if you'd like. Left hand down, right fingertips up. Coming all the way back up, right fingertips down, left hand up. And bringing it right back down. We're going to inhale all the way up. Almost done here. From here, we're going to turn to the side. Face your toes straight forward. Just coming into a nice little wide leg forward fold. So for the first one, I want you to swim your arms back, interlace them behind your back. Lift that chest very slowly on your exhale, forward fold. Getting a nice deep chest opener, getting into those legs. Maybe take your head from side to side. One more big inhale just like this. Exhale, very gently release. And another place it's safe to take a twist during pregnancy is in this forward fold. So we're going to leave our right hand down. Inhale your left fingertips all the way up. Keep your spine nice and straight. Your head is in line with your spine. Big deep breath in. Big exhale. Last inhale. Exhale, folding down, replacing your right hand with your left. Inhale those right fingertips all the way up. Try to stack your shoulders. Breathing nice and slowly. One more big inhale. Exhale, folding it right back down. Go ahead and bring your hands to your hips. Bend your knees and stand all the way up. Awesome. So almost done here. We're slowly going to make our way to seated. I want you to keep your feet planted nice and strong here. Take your hands underneath your shoulders, fingers pointing back towards your heels for a nice chest opener, a nice back bend. We're going to come into reverse tabletop. So take a big inhale. Exhale, lift your hips, press your chest all the way up. Stay strong through your hands. Try to lift your hips even with your knees, maybe even higher if you can. Feel that stretch in the front of your shoulders. Big inhale, exhale, release. We'll do one more of those. I don't know about you guys, but I know my baby is going crazy right now, loving this practice, so I hope yours are too. Keep your hands nice and strong. Big inhale. Exhale all the way up. Come on, mamas. You can do it. We're almost done. Big deep breath in. Big exhale. And very slowly release. So we're going to end in a nice seated position. Go ahead and loop those shoulders up and back. Maybe take some slow neck circles if that feels okay. Bring your hands to your belly, one hand on your baby, one hand near your heart. Bring your eyes to a close. And just check back in with your breathing. Let your baby know with each inhale how much you love them. Each exhale, just letting go of all the negativity in your life, all the hate. Making room for only love, only light, and only positivity. wish you nothing but health and happiness throughout the rest of your pregnancy and whenever your babies are finally here. Namaste.